What is up, beautiful people? My name is Tyler Lunsford, and welcome back to another magic trick review here on the channel. Now, if you're new here, then definitely please consider subscribing and take a look on the channel at my past reviews. I'm glad you're here, I hope you are, and without any more waiting, let's get right into this video. First off, you need to know, what actually is Cognito? Well, Cognito is the first magic app of its kind. Cognito is the closest you will ever come to experiencing the incredible power of telepathy. Imagine having a spectator think of anything, a playing card, star sign, word, movie, celebrity, etc., whatever they want. They never write it down, type it, point at it, click it, blink, or anything like that. The thought only exists in their mind. Yet, with Cognito, you know exactly what they are thinking. There's even a way to do it with no peek at all. Cognito is a revolutionary magic app that combines a classic principle with genius new methods to know what the spectators are thinking about with seemingly doing nothing. The reason reviewers are calling this the best app of the decade is because it has no competition. It stands on its own as the most unique and brilliantly thought out app ever created in the magic world. What will you be receiving if you decide to purchase this? Well, you'll be receiving the app itself with several presets for routines, along with a tutorial video that is about 1 hour and 21 minutes long, and on the tutorial you're going to learn multiple routines and even input methods using the Cognito app. Now that you know what Cognito is and what you'll be receiving, let's talk about some more questions you may have. Such as, how difficult is it to perform? Cognito is not difficult to use or perform. The hardest part is the presentation. If you can build a solid presentation around the strong app that it is, then you have something special in your hands. But if you're not willing to put in the time or put in the effort into creating either custom routines or just learning how the app works and, you know, making the most of it, then you're not going to get much out of it because you're not putting much into it. So just know that the amount of work and time that you put into this is going to correlate to the amount of, you know, awesome reactions you get and how well it looks to the spectator when you actually perform it to them. Let's talk about the angles. When you're performing this, what are the angles going to be like? The angles for Cognito are no problem. You can perform Cognito surrounded with pretty much no issues at all. Is Cognito examinable? Well, Cognito does not exist to the spectators, so they can't really examine something that they don't know exists. So you can let them hold onto your phone, obviously, during the routine, but they can't go tap crazy and just go search around your phone. But I mean, they need to look at the phone because they're gonna be swiping through photos or looking at them. So just know it is examinable to a certain extent, but also they don't even know that it really exists. Is there any DIY involved? The only DIY you would need to do is making custom presets, and that's completely optional. Other than that, there's not really any DIY at all. There's several custom presets already ready to go or just that come with the app already. So when you purchase it, you can go out and perform this right away once you learn it because they already include several different presets. You can also import custom presets that other people have made in the Facebook group, which if you bought this, definitely join the Facebook group. There are over 100 routines in there, I'm pretty sure, currently, that you can just download and import into your Cognito app. What's the setup and reset like for Cognito? The setup and reset for this happens all in real time, so there's not really much to worry about there. There is some initial setup you'll have to do when it involving making it look like you're going to your gallery. So once you get that set up, that's only gonna take a few minutes, but once you get that set up, then you're ready to go. You can perform it on the fly anytime. Also, your gallery does need to be on your homepage, so make sure that it is, because that will make this easy for you to do if it is. You don't have to worry about swiping over anything. So make sure your gallery is on your homepage. Are there any negatives when it comes to Cognito? Usually when I review magic apps, I always say something about how, what is your motivation to use your phone in a magic trick? I don't think that's an issue with this. You're handing someone Cognito. They don't know you're handing them Cognito, but you're handing them your phone because the photos you're pulling out to show your spectators have a reason to be shown, and that is because your spectators don't have these photos on their phone versus asking them to Google something on your phone when, you know, they have Google on their phone. They don't have these photos on their phone, so that's really not a negative there. The main negative that I see with this that could go wrong and has gone wrong for me in the past several weeks that I've been performing this, someone might not see the object in the photo. It is, like, whenever they're scrolling through, they might think they saw it or might think they didn't see it. Like, basically, they might get it wrong. They might say, yeah, I saw it, and just honest, it's an honest mistake. They didn't see it, or vice versa, which leads to wrong reveals or wrong peaks. And then when you have to figure out, hey, what, that wasn't, you know, you didn't choose the Jack of Diamonds? then it's kind of awkward for you. So make sure that you give them like the clearest instructions to actually get through this, because there's only so much you can do with audience management. One of the positives about Cognito: I really like how your spectators never say their card, zoom in on it, or write it down, or anything like that. It really does add mystery to the effect, and it just shows the power behind it. I also love how you can make your own custom versions to use the same principle that, you know, is basically, it's a utility principle that they've allowed you to apply to a bunch of different things. The principle this app uses is actually a classic, and it's something you probably have seen, like a kid's magic set. I know that when I was younger, I got a Chris Angel magic set for Christmas and a set of cards that came with it. Now, that used the same principle that this app does, and it's just so cool how Lloyd and Owen have adapted this principle to these different types of routines you can do with Cognito and using it with other objects. There are also multiple input methods, and they are all good. The input methods make it hands-free for the magician if they choose to do it that way. You can do it hands-free without any type of smartwatch. With that said, there is a way to use a smartwatch if you would like to, but that is completely optional. Another positive is there is not only the option to reveal the selected object as, you know, like a photo, but the option to do a peek or a peekless peek, which I kind of just mentioned with the smartwatch, you know, not using it or using it. So whatever object your audience chooses, without them even realizing you've seen it, they really thought out every single detail with this app. And as far as the design of the app and the usability, the UI, all that stuff, it's very, very easy to use as far as like getting your peek and things like that. And especially with the bug fixes that they've been doing in the past several weeks since it's been launched, they've been doing a lot of fixes, adding new routines. So they really are making sure that all the bases are covered here, and I do appreciate that. Another cool thing about Cognito is the tutorial video. It's filmed as a vertical video, which is awesome because you're probably going to be watching it from your phone since it is an app that you've just downloaded on your phone. So I just thought that was a nice touch, and I wanted to mention the great quality tutorial video taught by Lloyd. Now, when I say great quality, the camera quality is great, you know, audio, you can hear him fine. There has been some talk online about how the tutorial video necessarily wasn't that good on the teaching side, and I think that there are parts, you know, which need more clarification, and there has been some additional tutorial videos added since the release to clarify some things and also add some new ideas. So with all that said, I think they've clarified a lot, but I think Lloyd just got excited because he loves this app so much and all the things you can do with it, and he kind of might have brushed over some things or didn't really explain it as well as he could have, and some people just couldn't really completely grasp the concept of how to do certain things within the app. So if you do own this, or if you're thinking about getting it, whenever you do watch the tutorial video, watch it all the way through and watch all the tutorial videos. And remember to join the Facebook group so that way you can import your own copy of the custom presets that people have added into your own Cognito app. So just be aware of that. Join the Facebook group. What should this retail as? Well, currently Cognito will set you back about $40 US, and is that a fair price? Absolutely. For all the time and all the thought and the effort that's going into developing an app like this, absolutely it's worth the money. Could even be more in my opinion, especially with them, how they keep making the changes that people are requesting, essentially say, hey, I have a bug and this is what's going on. And if that's a common thing, they're getting these changes made pretty fast. So that's a good thing. I do think it's worth the money. I actually think it's worth a little bit more. And they actually just raised the price. So it did come out as $30. It's now gone up to $40. If you already bought it, that doesn't matter to you. But if you are thinking about buying it, just know that it did go up to $40, but I still think it's worth it, and I still think they could have charged more for it if they really wanted to. Thank you so much for sticking around until the end of this video. If you feel that Cognito is for you, then a link to purchase it is in the description down below. Remember, I am here to bring you unbiased reviews to help you make more informed, better decisions on the magic that you're going to buy, and I hope that you found this video helpful for that decision. I also bought this product with my own money, so you know that you are truly getting an unbiased magic review. And if you want to see performances and behind-the-scenes content, then head on over to my Instagram page at Tyler Lunsford Magic and consider following me on there. Hopefully I'll see you in another video that I post sometime soon, and remember, be nice to people. See ya.